Right, good afternoon, everyone. So good afternoon, Chloe, Chin, Dee, Ivan, Joseph, Jeff, Tom Ross, and welcome to our free online lesson for today. Right, so topik yang saya akan share untuk hari ini adalah Plant 3D to Nebis Work. Right, so what I'm going to do is that we're going to share the Plant 3D model inside of Navisworks, right? So for those who don't know Navisworks, so Navisworks is not actually a design software, but rather it is a software for project team to view a very large file, right? So inside of Navisworks, so we can use to view our Plant 3D model. Right, so let's take a look at our agenda for today. Right, so for untuk hari ini kita akan tengoklah. So first point is cara untuk kita nak import from Plant 3D model inside of Navisworks. Right, so kita akan import Plant 3D file and then kita akan view dia punya part-part file tu lah dalam tu. And then kita also boleh import part yang lain ataupun model yang lain into our same Navisworks file yang mana kita boleh collaborate between multiple models inside of one Navisworks. Next thing is kita nak tengok viewpoint and animation. Right, so inside of Navisworks is like I said before, it is for viewing purpose. So what it does is dia akan membuatkan kita punya Plant 3D and then ataupun mana-mana file akan jadi very light inside of Navisworks. Right, so let's say inside of Plant 3D or Inventor or Revit. So large file will be very hard to move sometimes, but inside of Navisworks it will be very light. So the next thing is once we view our model and so on, sometimes we might want to do make some notes or modifications, right? So we can do a markup, right? So dekat situ kita boleh letaklah kita punya measurement, right? So kita punya notes and so on. And the next thing is in Navisworks Manage yang boleh buat adalah clash detective. Right. So basically if we have multiple file, right, so yang mana kita nak combine sekali ataupun kita nak simply just to view our one Plant 3D file itself, we can use the clash detective untuk nak check lah whether kita punya model tu ada intersection between part by parts or clash. Right, so kita kita akan pakai clash detective. Then the last thing is inside of Navisworks, we can switch pad, right? So Navisworks is to view. So let's say we have view a certain area of our model, right? So kita nak alih semula ke kita punya Plant 3D, right? So for that kita boleh pakai switch pad, right? So without further ado, let me share my Plant 3D software, right? So first thing is I will open lah one of my Plant 3D file. So let's say this is my example of Plant 3D. Right, so I can make some adjustment, change, so or maybe I want to enter some of the equipment. Right. And then untuk masukkan file ni semua ke dalam Navisworks quite easy, right? So you don't need to convert because Navisworks can directly open DWG file. So what you have to do is just save, and then the next thing is kita boleh masuk proceed ke Navisworks untuk nak insert masukkanlah file tadi, right? So before I insert my DWG file or Plant 3D file, the two things is yang you kena make sure is that you might want to ensure to install Object Enabler, right? So kalau you tak install Object Enabler, most likely some of the parts or piping inside of Plant 3D dia akan show wireframe inside Navisworks. Right. So untuk nak install Object Enabler, so saya akan share the link. This is basically the link that you can use to download the Object Enabler installer and install it inside of your machine, right? So let me share. Oops, Let me share the link itself inside of chat. Right, so you can use this link to download the object enable. So let me share first lah inside of the browser. So let's say I open this link. Right, so dekat sini lah yang you boleh install. Right, you boleh download dia punya installer dia. Right, so let's say yeah, you kena make sure yang you punya object enable sesuai dengan you punya version lah. Right, so let's say you punya 2019, so you kena pilih 2019. Right, so quite easy. You boleh nampak dekat atas ni dia ada year kat sini, just ubah saja year ni. Right, 2019, and then it will show the suitable version of that you want to enter. Right, so without further ado, I already installed the project enabler inside of my inside of my machine, so I will continue lah. My Navis work. Right, so first thing is install object enable, and then the second thing is you might want to make sure that on the option over here, you can check the file reader. Right, so set to DWG. You might want to make sure that everything is set properly lah. Most important thing is the render here. Right, so you can check as automatic or render. But if you set as wireframe, so everything akan jadi wireframe lah. Even if you try change, they still wireframe. So make sure set up properly. Then kat atas ni ada face setting factor. Right, so by default dia bagi satu. So I want my object to be much smooth. So I choose 4 lah. Right. So now that is done. So untuk enter kita punya, untuk masukkan kita punya plant 3D model. So I can use append. Or I can just simply open over here and find my DWG file. So I go inside of my Plan 3D project and find the file that I have saved earlier. Right, so this one. So right now it will load everything from the Plan 3D inside of the Navis work. So you will see something that like this. Now if you want to change dia punya view, you can go to the viewpoint and then you can change dia punya render lah. Let's say I want shader. So you can change to shader. Then we also have wireframe. But if you like I said earlier, if from the option itself you just set awal lagi wireframe, so even though you try to change to full render or shaded, they still show as wireframe. Just to make sure lah, you pick the right option. Now, once we're here, we can take a look at some of the tools, right? So yang mana kita ada dekat dalam certain windows. So you can go to the view and then go to workspace and then window here. Right. So the tools that I want to show here is the first thing is the selection tree. Right, so di mana dia akan show lah file yang kita enter tadi. So we have the DWG file. So if I drop down here, dia akan tunjuk lagi file-file yang lain. Right, so contohnya macam piping number kat sini. Right, ataupun equipment kat sini. Right, so di mana yang dah assemble dekat dalam Plan 3D tadi. Right, so let's say I only want to see the piping only, so I can hide everything. Oops, can hide everything. And it will only show the piping. Right? So if I want back, so I can just simply unhide. So I can tunjuk kat sini. Now, the Navis work is quite useful to view multiple files. So let's say I want to enter another file, so I can go back to home, and I can use append to insert another file over here. Right. So in this case, I will select my another Navis work file. So let's say the lensing here. Right. So this is not actually from the Plan 3D that I have earlier, but I have from another one. Right. So we can view multiple file inside of one Navis work file. So that is the first thing. So that is for the Navis work, viewing multiple files. So let's say you make some changes inside of your Plant3D. So let's go back to the Plant3D. So let's say I create something like the plate dekat bawah dia. So let's say I create some plates, and then maybe I want to insert some instrument, right? So we go back to home and maybe I insert my equipment. So this one is the vessel, so let me move first. Right. So once that you have done, oops. Okay. So once you have done, create some changes over here, you can just simply save the file, right? And then you can go back to the Navis work. And all you have to do is refresh over here under the home tab. Just refresh and ia akan update balik lah yang mana changes yang you make dekat dalam dalam AutoCAD. So sepatutnya dia refresh, so let me go back to my AutoCAD. So maybe saya tak save tadi. Okay. It save. Let this work. So I may accidentally choose different file probably. Never mind, but if you do that, dia akan automatically refresh kat sini. So dia akan masuk kat sini. So the next thing is that you can do is that you can use it to view macam yang saya cakap tadi. So kita boleh pakai a few option kat sini. Right, so this is the normal view. Right. We can also do the walk and fly animation. So if I use the fly, I can move accordingly. Right. So quite slow. So I can also change from the navigate. Let's say I make it 10 speed. Right. So you can see that is much, much better. And then I can also simulate the walk. So let's say if I use the walk, I can also enter the gravity, so dia akan allow saya untuk move on the panel itself, right? So the reason why, so ini dia akan bawa saya ke bottom lah sebab I don't have the ground, right? So let me change back inside of the AutoCAD. So probably I choose the wrong file, so let me open the right one. So I'll choose back my project file over here. Right. So I believe this is the right one. So let me add some changes over here. Alright, so this is I add my equipment. Then maybe I want to add the floor. I can use the plate. Then I will save it here. Then go back to Navis work. Hopefully dia akan update lah. Right. So okay. So so bila dia update, dia akan refresh balik lah kat sini. Right. So I have my right file already. Right, so let's say I simulate the walk emission, and then I enter the gravity so that I can. Oops. Okay, I think. Right, so that I can letak kat sini. Right, so let me simulate the walk emission. Right. So seolah-olah macam kita berada dekat dalam ada plan 3D itself lah. Right? So quite easy to do simulation kat sini. Right? So if we want to see actual human size, we can also enable the third person. Right? So that can show something like this lah. Now that is for viewing option kat sini. Now let's say we want to save some of the view itself. Right, so contoh saya pergi dekat kawasan sini lah. And then I nak save the view kat sini. Right, so let me turn off the third person. Right, I want to save this particular view. To that, I can open my new windows for my viewport. Right, so don't need the selection tree anymore. So I will close this one. Right, and then I can go back to view and enable the save viewpoint. Right, over here, they can allow me to save this particular view. So let me save it. So just blue right click and save viewpoint. Then they can create this particular viewpoint. So we are name this as vessel. Right, and then I now save another view. So from this particular view. Ini saya namakan sebagai real. And then I can go into the front over here. In this time, I name it as farm. Right? So I can go back to the multiple view that I saved. Just simply select over here. That I can change according really. So that is for save the view. So let's say saya nak animate the view itself. So I can save multiple viewpoint and I can create an animation over there. Right, so let's say this is the new viewpoint I want. And then I create another one over here. And then I zoom in, create another one right over here. Right, so let's so right now I have three view. Yang mana saya boleh convert this tree into into animation, right? So I can just simply right click and add animation, and then the tree view yang saya create earlier, so saya boleh just drag saja dekat dalam animation over here. Now, dekat sini dia akan animate the tiga-tiga view lah. So I can go back to my animation, right? So select my animation over here, and I can play it from here. So dia akan masukkan from viewpoint to viewpoint. Right. So that is for viewing purpose and animation. So the next thing is yang kita nak tengok pula is if you want to do some markup. Right. So let's say if I go over here and saya nak review this particular model. So let's say I can go into review. Let's say I want to measure. So saya nak tengok lah. Berapa distance from this one to this this bar over here. So I can use measure and select from point to point. Right, so dia akan bagi perspective measure lah. If I want to measure from one object to another one, I can select both object, this one and this one, and I can go back to my review and I can select shortest distance. So this one dia akan calculate dan enter the shortest distance lah, right? So distance yang paling dekat sekali. Dan dia akan sini. Now, kalau you notice, measurement yang saya buat earlier, dia akan padam. Right? So if I use new measure, so this one will akan hilang lah. Right? So if we want to use this measure as our markup, we can convert this to red line. So if I convert to red line, so dia akan jadi red line dan dia akan create as my new view. So which means I can only see this from this particular view only. So if I move another one, so dia akan hilang lah. So I can go back to my view and review back my my measure over here. Then I can also input some markup over here. So let's say I now create some cloud, so I can review, and I can also input my text over here. Right, so this one only available dekat dalam this view only. So if I move, dia akan hilang. And then if I can go back, so I can review back lah. Right, I can also rename this one from this review. Right, so next time is I can just simply go over here. So that is basically for markup. And then the next thing is, let's say you nak simulate the class detection, right? So maybe waktu you buat modeling dekat dalam Plan 3D, you nak tengoklah whether ada intersection between two models, right? For that, I can go into home and use the class detective, right? So just simply select the class detective. Then dekat sini dia akan show lah my available selection for my part yang mana saya boleh select lah. So either saya ada this plan 3D and also the this model over here, the lensing, right? So let's say saya nak tengok dia punya between these two, so I can select these two and run test. But of course these two takkan ada clash lah sebab dia further apart. So what I want to do right now is I want to check between this part foundry, so I can select back the same file also. And then I can just simply run my test and dia akan highlight dan show lah every class yang dia dah detect over here. Alright, so again, so sekarang ni tak begitu clear, so let me change my view. Alright, so dah nampak dah. So I can review back any class that yang ada dekat dalam Plan 3D ni. Now let's say I need to do some notes over here. I can also assign, right? So I can click assign over here. So maybe saya nak bagi my colleague Adam, right? So I can also add notes over here. Then maybe I want to see another file over here. So let's say kat sini kita ada the view. Kat sini kita ada new kat sini, which indicates this one is new new found. Right, so dekat atas ni, the test that I have created earlier. So dia akan list down all available crash kat sini. So for example, we have 45 crash. Right, so yang baru jumpa dia akan create as the new one lah. So 45 new class has been found. So let's say this one are already review and so on. So I can just simply select for review. And then dia akan automatically highlight over here. So this one is already review. So maybe class number 6 already being fixed. So I can change the status to resolve. So they can automatically move to resolve lah. Right, so I can see. So, yang mana yang the new one over here. Now, let's take a look at, for example, this one. So, this is one of the clashes that I found, and then I nak changes dekat dalam Plan 3D. Right. So, to do that, I can also use the switchback. Right. So, we can use the button over here. So, kalau tak nampak, boleh just drop down from the item over here. Right. So kita boleh tekan switch back and then dia akan terus masuk dekat dalam AutoCAD lah. So before we use that switch back option, bila dekat dalam Plan 3D, you must make sure to enter the command NW load. Right, so enter, make sure to enter this one, only then dia dapat detect lah dekat dalam Navisworks. Right, so from Navisworks I choose the switch back and then dia akan pop out dekat dalam AutoCAD lah. So let me open my AutoCAD, and then automatically dia akan show this particular view, right? So I can select this one and make some changes and some correction over here, and I can save back, and then go back to my Navis work. And when I refresh, dia akan automatically fix dan dia akan padamlah crash number 17 ni. Right, so already fix already. So you don't actually need to use the clutch detective kalau you nak tengok switchback, but you can also simply select. So for example, this particular view, and right click and select the switchback. Right, so you can go back to your Plan 3D, and then automatically they akan change the particular view. Right, so that is basically one of the few things that you boleh buat lah from from AutoCAD Plan 3D into the Navis world. So that is all that I would like to share for today. So kalau ada apa-apa question, boleh just type in dekat ruangan chat before I end for today lah. Alright, so before I end, I would like to run my poll. Alright, so just for your review lah for this particular free online lesson for today. Alright, so I will give another 5 seconds before I end my my poll. Alright, so thank you everyone for joining for today. Thank you for doing our polls. Right, so I will end this poll. Right, so thank you. And before I end my session, so I believe no more question for you guys. I would like to share last thing about the product design and manufacturing collection. Now, if you buy the PDMC collection, you akan dapat semua produk lah kat sini. Right, so for example, if you don't know what is PDMC collection, which is stand for Autodesk Product Design and Manufacturing Collection, yang mana dia adalah bundle yang mana ada multiple produk lah kat dalam ni. Contohnya ada AutoCAD, which is including AutoCAD 72 set such as mechanic, AutoCAD mechanical, electrical, plan 3D and so on. And then dekat dalam ni also ada inventor professional, ada inventor Nastran, CAM, and also have the cloud software. Right. So if you buy the PDMC, total you akan dapat lebih kurang 23 software. So quite benefit lah. Right. So I guess no more question for you guys. So that is all from me. Right. So thank you for joining everyone. Right, so thanks Jeff, Tom Roth, Matt, Ivan, Chloe, Matt. Right, so thank you everyone. So that is all from me. Have a nice day, and I hope I see you guys again on our next free online lesson.